All right, so we're gonna start using an IDE from this point forward. So I'm gonna walk you through the steps. Using an IDE will make your development much easier because it provides code completion and error checking as you go. The first thing I'm gonna do is start NetBeans. Once I'm in NetBeans, I'm gonna create a new Java project. A project is just a collection of files to make an application. I'll select File, then New Project. This will bring up a dialog window. I'm going to select Maven for the category. Maven is a tool used to build larger projects. It also makes it much easier to take source code on one machine to another and have it compile. It's something I recommend that you look into. All the Java tutorials on dgu.com are going to use Maven. There are two tutorials to give you a deeper look at Maven if you like. For the project type, I'm going to select Java Application. Hit Next. For the name, I'm going to use Primitives. You can call it anything you like. This is the name to reference your project. NetBeans will use the name for other parts here. You can just accept the defaults and click Finish. This creates an empty project. So now we need to add a Java file to edit. Open the Source Packages folder. There should be something called a package under the Source Packages folder. If there isn't, select Default Package. This is something that we're going to cover in later lessons. Right-click and select New. Then select New Class. Name the class Primitives Example and click Finish. This will create a Java file. Look familiar? It should look similar to the Hello World app we created in the last lesson. It's just missing the main method in the Hello World part. So let's add the main method. Then add the print statements to say Hello World. We just want to test the IDE. The pop-ups you see as I type are called code completion windows. It's trying to complete what I type. I'll just say test instead of Hello World. Let's save the file by going to the file, and then save. Now let's run the application. Select Run, then Run Project. The first time you run this, it's going to ask what class it should use for a main method. We only have one, so the choice is pretty easy. It should compile and run the application in the console window. The console is the area at the bottom of the IDE. It mimics what you'd see if you ran it from a command line. It prints more than normal here because we're using Maven to compile, but you can see it printed test, so it works. And that's how we're going to create projects for Java applications. Hey, thanks for watching the video. There's a quick quiz for this on dgu.com if you'd like to gauge how much you learned. If you like the videos you're seeing, please let me know by liking the video and hitting the subscribe button for the DGU channel on YouTube. I'd really appreciate that. If you have concerns or questions, please leave them in the comments below or on DGU.com. There's a poll on the front page of DGU.com, so you can also let me know what topic gets covered next. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.